Okay, so I return to you now that I'm level 70. I've got 62 hours and 47 minutes clocked into this game. And I've 100%ed the collection. I can tell you that this is probably the hardest thing I've ever done in my life, but it was worth it. So let's look at the cards I got. Soldier, Power Wild, Bouncy Wild, Large Body, Fat Bandit. Got the Pirate card. Power card's actually pretty nice. Changes the values of all cards to zero. I haven't tried it out yet. Blue Rhapsody, Green Requiem, Wizard, Air Soldier, Barrel Spider, White Knight, Air Pirate, Gargoyle, Aqua Tank, Weavern, Defender, White Mushroom. White Mushroom is probably the hardest. What I end up doing is using Warp and Warpinator. I wouldn't recommend you even use White Mushroom cards. Don't really make any White Mushroom rooms until you have the Warpinator slate, which is, I believe, Stop Gravity Arrow. And what that does is it pretty much one hits the enemy. It doesn't always work. So you might want to use a Marluxia card, get two of the slate. Marluxia card, of course, doubles it, so you'd be able to use the one slate twice. And you'd want to keep doing that until you get the White Mushroom card. Because otherwise, if you're just doing it the traditional way, it'll take forever. Tornado Snap. You could use Warp, but it's not as efficient. But it does kind of clear the room, and you don't get experience for Warp. Neo Shadows are also good because it drains enemy HP. So as you can see, they're all stars, but why isn't that a star? Like, why isn't it reading that my card collection is complete? Well, I'll tell you why. There's actually two hidden cards that you could only get when you 100% the cards. Let's go into Castle Oblivion real quick. And make us a... Oh, crap. I don't actually have any... treasure rooms. Alright, so let's go into a roulette room. You can really see how much I've been doing this. Like, I had to actually empty out all of my room cards a few times simply because I was getting too many of them. I rebuilt my deck, of course, again. Now it's just 9s, 8s, and 7s. I use as many cards as I could with the, CP I have. My CP is a lot higher. I don't have a item card on, an enemy card, but I do have Mega Elixir. Now that I have a good level Mega Elixir. I was very much a repeat customer to the old Moogle shop while I was off-screen. I think I actually still have like several Weavern cards, because the last one I ended up getting was the last one I got was the Defender, and in the process I was trying to get a Weavern as it was. Let's go for this level 3 Common Bounty. And I do want another Common Bounty. So let me grab that before I get rid of this room. Oh, what I got here? Bond of Flame level 7. That's actually something I would like. Alright. So this is in no way a slate deck. It is strictly a just my high-level card deck at that. It really does fend against the higher-level enemies very well, to a certain extent. There's still times where I do need to use slates, and this deck really isn't built for slates. I don't know if I explained this very well, but Trinity Limit works with any combination of Keyblade, Goofy and Donald card, as long as it's in the order that isn't Goofy Charge, which is Goofy Donald Sora. If it's in any other combination other than Goofy Donald Sora, it enters tree limit after you enter this world. I do want to, at one point, get a max level in this game. That will, however, take me much longer time. I will probably do that, I'll do that probably off-screen, make one episode in the end, with, like, a master deck and, well, like, three different master decks, of course. One for every slot. One of them will probably be a slate deck, of course. One of them will just be a straight nine deck, using as many of the cards as I can. So yeah, that's probably how I'm gonna do that. And that's probably gonna be a special episode that I will return to in due time. Let me grab this level 6 cotton bounty. Just what I wanted. I actually thought I had cotton bounties, but I actually like finished collecting it all last night, and it was too late to record another episode, so it's like, yeah, I'll just wait until tomorrow morning. So let's pop the cotton bounty. Now, hopefully, what this will do is give me the card I'm looking for. The gold card. Okay, so that's one of two cards. Let's go to the journal. The gold card, of course, appears at the end. It is one of the two special cards. The other one is hidden, of course. And it allows this one allows premium cards to be reloaded for 5 reloads. So that's really good for a slate deck. Let's actually look at how expensive that card is. Because it counts as enemy card. It is 99, quite the same way as the Roxas and a lot of the other... there's only three right now. Luxord, Roxas, and the gold card. Now, if I pop that again... Let me just grab whatever's here. Whatever little bit of Moogle points I can scrounge up. Oh, like diamond dust, that was worth it. I would have been really suffering if I didn't grab that, because I have been trying to get that card in higher quantity. My cat just figured out a way to open the door again. Now, if I open this again, what it should be able to happen is I should get the other special card, the Platinum card. Now, the Platinum card is something special. Invincible. You will receive no damage for 20 attacks. Now, of course, I am now... My journal's done. The only thing really left to do now at this point is max out my stats. I believe that the stats max out. After you have all the slates, that is, your max CP is 1,625, and your max HP is 560. And I believe that's at level 99. But basically, once you get 1625 CP, it cancels out at CP, and you can only get HP at that point. At which point you can get your HP up to, I believe, 560 point, which is a really good amount. I mean, where I am at the 400 something 45, I mean, it is like another like 50 added to it, like more than that even. I'm not doing the math. You know what I mean. But I do have all the enemy cards, which is great. Let me just pop a... I actually got 3 random jokers in the process. And it's like, I'm not even going to use these. I mean, at the point where I am, where I only have the only thing remaining are, of course, the enemy cards. I already have all the room rewards. It's like, why do I even bother? I didn't really get anything good that time. Let me see if I can get rid of some cards. I got 3 level 9 ultimo weapons. That's really nice. Alright. So I really only need 3 of each of these. And I don't want anything that's under a 7 anyway. So I could get rid of this like one winged angel because I have 2 8s and a 9. For example. Get rid of 2 of these diamond dusts. I'm going to keep the ultimo weapon. Just for the sake of having it. Keep level 8, of course. Just get rid of these level 5s. Level 6s. Alright, with that, I should be able to buy this deck right here. You know, again with these premium cards, I really do not like the premium cards. But oh well, it's something I'll have to deal with. I'm just gonna get rid of them, actually. So those are the 2 special cards. There are... actually 3 on the table enemy cards. The Honeybee, Marluxia's second form, and Marluxia's third form. Those are the only cards that are in the game that you can't get. But that is where that lies. What else am I thinking? The room to reward cards. Hold on. I believe the room to reward cards, the way they work is with the key to rewards, of course, in the original Chain of Memories, there's only the first set, which is in Agrabah, it's Warp, Quake, just going down the list, Warp, Quake, Super Glide, Mega Elixir, Bind, Mushu, Aqua Splash, Thunder Raid, Metal Chocobo, Lionheart, Stardust Blitz, and Synchro. In the original, it was Blazing Donald, Quake, Mega Elixir, Gravity Raid, Mushu, Aqua Splash, Thunder Raid, Metal Chocobo, Lionheart, Warp, and Stop Raid. That first set you get normally, and that's just the normal room to reward rewards. If you have completed Source Story, however, or you have like a Kingdom Hearts 2 save file, at that point you could have the if you have both Sora Story completed and a Kingdom Hearts 2 save file, then the second treasure chest would appear only in ReChain Memories, which is Luxor, Demix, the Star Seeker, Photon Debugger, Bond of Flame, Zigbar, Zaldin, Follow the Wind, Monochrome, Sykes, Roxas, and Xamnas. This also works if you have the Japanese version, if you have completed Riku's Story, Reverse Rebirth, or if you have the Japanese Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix save on your memory card. That's, of course, for the Japanese version. That will allow the both chests to appear. Of course, I had a Kingdom Hearts 2 file, and I had already beat Sora story once, so that was there for me. So if only one of the chests is emptied at the point, the other chest will function as a calm bounty chest until both unique chests are obtained. And of course, you can only carry one kid rewards at a time. How far in am I? 15 minutes? Whereabouts am I? I'm going to make a bum rush to Marluxia, see if I can take him on. And I'm going to end it with that, actually. Of course, you just use a mingling world. Just see what it does for me. And of course, after this, I will be starting Jack 3 up. I have bought a PSP. It's just a matter of whenever it comes in. I will be starting up that. I'll be starting up Birth by Sleep. And I'm also getting Daxter as well. So I can add that to the list of games played in the Jack Nexter series. So I'm probably going to do Birth by Sleep and Daxter after doing Kingdom Hearts 2. As well as Kingdom Hearts 2, as well as Jack 3. I do want to finish those before I start playing around with my PSP, trying to record off that. But I do believe I have discussed that. I am also looking into playing the games Game Dev Tycoon, which I've seen a few people play. It does look like a really good game. I did recently just get myself a copy of it. I've been having a lot of fun with it. Pretty decent game in it itself. Oh, look what I just got. Calm Bounty. Level 0. So I will be playing around with that a bit. There's also, what was it called? There's this other game that I was looking at. I don't remember the name of it, but it's practically a type of level 7 monochrome. That's nice. It's like a Minecraft-esque type of game that mixes like some aspects of like Terraria in stuff like that. What do I want to put here? Yeah, let's just use up the other mingling worlds. Actually, what was the name of that game? It was Starforged. That's what I was thinking. So I do hope to start up Starforge after buying myself a copy. I will be going for the Forger's bonus, so my name will be in the credits. Which is pretty cool. I actually like the way they're doing that. How many more rooms do I have? 1, 2, 3. These are all going to be random jokers. So I am looking at playing Starforge. Game Tev Tycoon. That's a Feeble Darkness. Nice. So that you can look forward to as well. Of course, Jack 3. I'll start recording that as soon as I'm done recording this. Start up the first episode. I am planning a 100% run. Look forward to it. Another thing that some of you might enjoy. If you have ever worked with RPG Maker, be it 2003, VXS. I am actually starting up a project just to entertain myself, really, more than anything else. It will be all of Kingdom Hearts and Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories remade in their entirety in RPG Maker VXS. I will be making videos regularly, just walking through what I'm doing exactly. And I do plan to do a few videos like that, not a lot, but of course when I'm done with it, I will share it for you. I mean, it's not going to be something that I'm going to, like, try to make any money off of course. It's like, it's just going to be something I'm going to do to entertain myself, really. And it'll be like identical to Kingdom Hearts. Come on, stop hitting that. In that, like all the dialogues will be the same. I'm just gonna make it so it's a top-down random encounter style of RPG, which is what RPG Maker specializes in. If you don't like the idea that I'm doing it, I'm just doing it to entertain myself. I'm not trying to like take any credit from Square Enix or anything. I mean, it's just a great game that I feel like. I mean, like, all the stats are online. It's not like it's, like, hidden from anyone. And it's like, I've played through the game so many times. I've memorized, like, where all the Dalmatians are at this point. Like, all the Trinities. I mean, just, like, just to be able to entertain myself, learn how to make the RPGs in that program, for one. Yeah, I think it'll be kind of cool. So, go over here. Did I say you could move away from me?
Your heart will be scattered. Heal. Heal.
If you want to scream.
No good.
Okay, I'm actually not doing as well as I thought I would be doing. But oh well. I'm not really freaking out about it, you know?
Your heart.
Come on! Can you stop moving around so damn much? Oh, that sucked.
No good.
Yeah, I mean, again, it's not a ridiculously hard fight. I wonder how much this is actually gonna do. I mean, I don't think it'll do too much. I actually did take him down a life bar.
You want to scream?
No good.
Yeah. So, I mean, I do have a lot of plans for the future, and I hope that you'll enjoy it all the way through. That's pretty much where that lies. This is probably gonna be the last episode of Chain of Memories until I am, of course, done with getting my Sora to level 100, maxing out my stats, revealing my deck. And at that point, I will make the episode solely me rematching. Marluxia. With the max stats, just to see how I do against them. Alright. So, yeah, I am doing pretty well against them. Of course, it isn't a rough fight. I mean, once you've got it all down, I mean, the way that I do, I mean, there's no reason I should be having trouble with this fight at this point anyway. I mean, especially with, like, all these level 9 cards as it is. The only problem I would be having is running out of cards. Of course, I'm not using Slate, so it's not really a problem. It's all just a matter of, like, not wasting my cards. One thing I should mention, the Dark Ball cards. is the Dark Ball is the only enemy that doesn't have a card for Sword Story. The card is for the Riku story only, and it automatically starts a card duel. In the original Chain of Memories, it was a multiplayer card for when you do like multiplayer battles, and what it does is make it so the person you're playing against can't see your cards. But of course, there's no multiplayer functionality in ReChain of Memories, so they scrapped that entirely. Whoops, didn't want to pop that. Yeah. Oh well. Whoops. Too far away for that to work.
Your heart will be soon. No good. Still be.
Okay, get it, Gil Severance.
No good. The cards will determine your fate.
That wasn't hard at all, actually. Yeah, I mean, the only problem is with the slates. Once you get down to, like, the fact where you still need to break a slate. Oh, shit. I guess that actually reloaded my cards for me in a sense, though. Which is good. High-level slates to make it so he can't use his, and you should be all set with this fight. I mean, it's not even really a hard fight. I think the fight prior to this is actually a harder fight. The only hard part is with the slates itself. Which is, I guess, the way they always did the fights in this game. The entire franchise, it always has been the type of thing where, there's always, like several battles. Oh, so that's how you use Sun Blade. Oh, bugger. Doom, of course, is very reminiscent of, not Doom, the other move that he used. It's very reminiscent of the move that Xemnas uses, the end boss of the two. Doom just came pretty much like similar to the battle system. So, beat Marluxia again. Wonderful. Alright, so I played it 100% Jirtle. I'm a card master. I've defeated 6,506 enemies. I have all of the special treasures. I've broken 6,953 cards. I've used Fire Raid 425 times. And I cleared the game in 63 hours and 22 minutes. Go ahead and save this. I eventually do also want to do a, I do want to revisit this game when it gets remade for the, this and Kingdom Hearts 1 are both being remade for the, PlayStation 3, like HD. I will be revisiting this game because there will be more things added to it. I don't know what, but I also wanted 100% the trophies on screen, and it won't be hard to do. I already did this. It'll just be a matter of me revisiting the game. I believe that the HD version of Kingdom Hearts 1 is Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, which was already exclusive to Japan until now. So now that it's coming out for PS3... I'll be able to do my playthrough of Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, which I'll have a lot of fun with. And since it's PS3, I'll be able to get all the trophies. You'll be able to watch along the way. I will be, of course, doing those playthroughs in Proud Mode. I'm telling you right now. So it'll be a good distance longer than the original playthroughs. But it'll be more of a challenge for me, it'll be a lot more fun, and it'll be a lot more of me goofing around in the game, of course. So I will see you next time with Let's Play Jack 3. I had a lot of fun with this Let's Play. I hope you have a lot of fun watching it. If you have any questions, feel free to message me. If you want me to give you any pointers about any of the enemy cards, any tactics that I used off-screen, because I know a lot of them I didn't show, for good reason. It killed me to do them. It literally took me 60 hours to finish this game in its entirety, just on the source story alone. About 6.5 hours for the Riku story, because I bum-rushed through it in beginner mode. But I will be doing both Riku story and source story in Proud mode when I get my PS3 hooked up and I get that remix. So if you do have any questions and I don't address it, message me. I'll probably address it. If I don't, I will address it when I do that playthrough in HD. I'll see you next time. This is EchoingClock. Goodbye.